Welcome to Sierra Center Stage. Recorded live in the big room at Sierra Nevada Brewing Company in Chico, California. Featuring intimate performances and interviews with legendary masters of authentic roots music. This week, Guy Clark and his frequent collaborator Verlon Thompson deliver a rousing performance of the widely celebrated singer-songwriter's most popular tunes. Plus, a special appearance from the legendary Ramblin Jack Elliott.
Good evening, everybody. It's like deja vu all over again. Welcome to Sierra Center Stage here at the Sierra Nevada Brewing Company in Chico, California. We're glad you're here. I seem to have been on a Texas bent lately. I'm married a Texas woman. I bring in Texas talent, and Texas must be a good thing. I'm going to present to you now one of the true Texas songwriting legends. He's a long, tall Texan, but he's got the heart and soul of a poet. Please welcome Guy Clark.
Thanks. Well, now, this is my dear friend, Verlon Thompson. We're going to play you some songs we know. Maybe a couple we don't. This is a song about jumping off the garage. With a flour sack cape tied all around his neck, he climbed up on the garage. He's figuring what the heck. Screwed his courage up so tight that the whole thing come unwound. He got a running start, and bless his heart, he headed for the ground. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms, hold your breath, and always trust your cape. Now he's all grown up with a flour sack cape tied all around his dreams. And he's full of piss and vinegar, he's busting at the seams. So he licked his finger and then he checked the wind. He said it's gonna be do or die. He wasn't scared of nothing. He's pretty sure he could fly. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your game. That cape tied all around his head, and he's still jumping off the garage, and will be till he's dead. All these years the people said he's acting like a kid. He did not know he could not fly, so he did.
Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms, hold your breath, and always trust your cape. Yeah, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cape. Spread your arms, hold your breath and always trust your cape. Pack up all your dishes, make note of all good wishes, say goodbye to the landlord for me. That son of a bitch has always bored me. Throw out them L.A. papers, molded box of vanilla wafers. Adios to all this concrete. Gonna get me some dirt road back street. If I can just get off of this L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Down that road in a cloud of smoke to some land. Only one I think I will miss. I can hear that old bass singing, sweet and low like a gift you're bringing. Play it for me one more time now. Got to give it all we can now. I believe everything you're saying. Just you keep on, keep on playing. Something we have forgotten. Oh, Susanna, don't you cry, babe. Love's a gift that's surely handmade. We got something to believe in. Don't you think it's time we're leaving? I can just get off of this silly freeway without getting killed or caught. Down that road in a cloud of smoke to some land. I ain't bop. I can just get off of this L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Down that road in a cloud of smoke to some land. I ain't. Pack up all your dishes, make note of all good wishes, say goodbye to the landlord for me. That son of a bitch has always bored me.
Thanks.
There's a good story that goes with Stuff That Works. I think it was 1992, and I was tired. Actually, I was in a funk and pouting, and I just sort of telling everybody, oh, I'm through with it. This was before I actually did take myself out of the game. I said, I'm gonna quit. I've had enough. This is no fun anymore. And I was kind of being a baby. Guy knocks on the door, shows up in my house with a guitar in his hand, and he says, shut up. Yeah, I've heard all about it, you know. Guy's inimitable in that way, and a real presence, you know. He said, come on, let's write a song. So we started working on Stuff That Works, and he had the idea. He says, yeah, I'm gonna write this song about stuff that works, you know, and it's not stuff you put on the wall, it's stuff that's meaningful in your life. So by the end of that day, and he came back the next day and we finished it, I was, by the end of those 2 days, I was back in the music business.
This is a real pretty song I wrote with a friend of mine named Rodney Crowell. I got an old blue shirt and it suits me just fine. I like the way it feels, so I wear it all the time. I got an old guitar, won't ever stay in tune. I like the way it sounds in a dark and empty room. I got an old pair of boots and they fit just right. Well, I can work all day, I can dance all night. I got an old used car and it runs just like a top. I get the feeling it ain't ever gonna stop. Stuff that works, stuff that holds up, the kind of stuff you don't hang on the wall. Stuff that's real, stuff you feel, the kind of stuff you reach for when you fall. Got a pretty good friend who's seen me at my worst. He can't tell if I'm a blessing or a curse. But he always shows up when the chips are down. And that's the kind of stuff I like to be around. Stuff that works, stuff that holds up, kind of stuff you don't hang on the wall. Stuff that's real, stuff you feel, the kind of stuff you reach for when you fall. Woman I love, she's crazy and paints like God. She got a playground sense of justice, she won't take odds. I got a tattoo with her name right through my soul, and I think everything she touches turns to gold. Stuff that works, stuff that holds up, kind of stuff you don't hang on the wall. Stuff that's real, stuff you feel, the kind of stuff you reach for when you fall.
But in the early 1970s, Guy Clark was more like a curator in Nashville. He was the curator of good songs, and the methodology that, of the process that you use to get to good songs. And he was constantly in this circle of crazy songwriters, always keeping everybody focused on, yeah, it's the song. It's the song. It's more, you know, there is no music business without the song. So he pulled me aside one day and said, okay, he says, you got talent. He said, but decide. He said, you want to be an artist or a star? He said, either one's fine. He said, pick one and focus on it. And of course I knew, you know, the side of the fence he fell on. So I said, oh, I want to be an artist. I want to be an artist. And I never forgot that.
About 10, 15 years ago, I was down in Austin, Texas, for Jerry Jeff Walker's birthday bash and soiree. Well, we bashed. We got bashed. 4 or 5 people got soiree'd. I heard. I ran these 2 yahoo friends of mine, one named Ramlin Jack, Elliott. Sure, by now you know they don't call him Ramlin Jack because he travels around a lot. And this other guy named Larry Mahan is maybe the world's best rodeo cowboy ever. And Jack and I figured anybody's crazy enough to get on a bull is our kind of guy. So the 3 of us decided, well, I don't know if we decided, but we certainly proceeded to stay up all night, greet the dawn in Austin, Texas, just to make sure. So Ramblin' Jack Elliott said, I got these lines in my face, trying to straighten out the wrinkles in my life. When I think of all the fools I've been, it's a wonder that I've sailed this many miles. To which Larry Mahan replied, he said, the sweet bird of youth sitting on my shoulder yesterday, but she's always changing partners, and I always knew she'd up and fly away. We're staying up all night in the Driscoll Hotel, Ramblin' Jack and Mayhem, the cowboy at all the hell, and the room smelled like bull. Words sound like songs. Now there's a pair to draw. 2 boys, I would not steer you wrong. Said, I recall a time I set my soul on fire just for show. And all it ever taught me was the more I learned, the less I seemed to know. Mayhem crawled in off the ledge and said, Jack, he said, as far as I can see, mistakes are only horses in disguise. Ain't no need to ride them over. Hell, we could not ride them different if we tried. We're staying up all night in the Driscoll Hotel, Ramblin' Jack and Mayhem, this cowboy at all the hell,
smell like bulls, the words sound like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys I would not steer you wrong. We're staying up all night in the Driscoll Hotel. Ramblin' Jack and Mayhem was cowboyed all the hell. And the room smelled like bulls, the words sounded like songs. Now there's a pair to draw, two boys you could not steer you wrong.
Tell you a little, that's an oxymoron, a little bit about Jack Elliott. Oh, Jack is just wonderful. I've known who Jack is for 35, 40 years, you know, from my beginnings as a traditional music singer and folk singer, and Jack was always there. And then when I met him, I guess 25 years ago, I've known him, I was just stunned, and I'm still stunned. I learned a lot from Jack. First of all, that there are no rules. You don't have to do anything the same way twice. You don't have to do anything. All you gotta do is be Jack Elliott, or yourself. It's not be Jack, but be yourself. And that's an invaluable thing to know.
I'd like to do a song I learned from Ramblin Jack about, oh Lord, 25, 30 years ago, and I'm going to get Jack to come out here and sing it. Yeah. This is Jack Elliott. I remember the first time I heard this was about 1963 from the Newport Folk Festival.
I was there.
You were there.
I know, because somebody just told me so last week.
I remember Jack introduced, he said, "This old cowboy song I learned from a cowboy from Brussels."
He was from Texas, but they had a rodeo in Brussels. American Rodeo. They had 60 cowboys and 60 Sioux Indians there. And he was one of them, George Williams, bronc rider. Yeah, and he taught me this song.
Kick it off.
I'm not rambling. There's a man you'll hear about most every place you go. Holdings are in Texas, and his name is Diamond Joe. And he carries all his money in a diamond-studded jaw. And he never was much bothered by the process of the law.
I hired out the Diamond Joe boy, I did offer him my hand. And he gave me a string of horses so old they could not stand. I'd like to starve to death for he did mistreat me so. I never saved a dollar in the pay of Diamond Joe.
Well, his bread it was Corn Dodger, and his meat I couldn't chew. And he drove me near distracted with the wagging of his jaw for the telling of his stories. I aim to let you know there never was a rounder that lied like Diamond Joe.
Play one, Verlon.
To quit him, boys, but he did argue so that I'm still punching cattle in the pay of Diamond Joe. And when I'm called up yonder and it comes my time to go, give my blankets to my buddy and give the fleas to Diamond Joe.
Jack Elliott.
When I was going to college, Jack Elliott was one of my heroes. I saw him play in Berkeley. I saw him play in San Francisco. Every house when you're a college student has a house song. Well, 912 Greens was our house song. And we'd get up in the morning and put that on, and it would start our day. And the fact that we were able to present Jack as part of our show is a real privilege.
Yates and Jeans got up to play guitar and sing in some joint in Mission Beach last night. At the door sat Tom Waits in a pork pie hat and silver skates, and he's juggling three collection plates. Jesus Christ. Towns Van Zandt was standing at the bar skinning a Hollywood movie star. Can't remember where he parked his car, to whom he lost the keys. Oh, but he's full of angst and hillbilly haiku. What's a poor Fort Worth boy to do? Go on, rhyme something for a man, show him how you really feel.
You know there ain't no money in poetry, that's what sets a poet free. I've had all the freedom I can stand. Cold dog soup and rainbow pie, all it takes to get me by. Fool my belly till the day I die. Cold dog soup and rainbow
and Kerouac was shooting dice and playing Ramlin Jack's guitar with a cowboy painting pick guard on it. Oh, and they sat in the back and they drank for free and they rhymed orange with Rosalie. Well, there's a pride of lines to draw to.
I said there ain't no money in poetry, and that's what says the poet free. I've had all the freedom I can stand. Thompson rainbow pie. All it takes to get me by. Fool my belly till the day I die. Cold dog soup and rainbow pie. Ain't no money in poetry. That's what says a poet free. I've had all the freedom I can send. Got the cold dog soup and rainbow pie. All it takes to get me by. Fool my belly till the day I die. Cold dog soup and rainbow pie.
Guy Clark had a profound effect on me as was a profound influence on me. Number one, because he's one of the greatest writers in America, the world, and he and I maintain that he is the best self-editor that I've ever come across, and it's like self-editing, like with a jeweler's eye, just. Precision self-editor, and I admire the courage that comes with that kind of self-editing.
This is a song about a guy who's kind of like my grandfather. Actually, it was my grandmother's boyfriend. But he was a wildcatter out in West Texas, and that means you drill oil wells just for the hell of it. Doesn't really matter if you get anything. It's a sport. From it all. But he's got taught me how to whittle and spit, cuss, drive a car, and sit up straight. And I play the Red River Valley. And he'd sit in the kitchen and he'd cry and run his fingers through 70 years of living. Wonder, Lord, has every well I drill gone dry? We were friends, me and this old man, like desperados waiting for a train. Like desperados waiting for a train. Well, he's a drifter and a driller of oil wells, and an old school man of the world. He taught me how to drive his car when he's too drunk to. Oh, and he'd wink and give me money for the girls. And our lives were like some old western movie. Like desperados waiting for a train. Like desperados waiting for a train. From the time that I could walk, he'd take me with him to a bar called the Green Frog Cafe. There was old men with beer guts and dominoes. Oh, and they're lying about their lives while they'd play. And I was just a kid, but they all called his sidekick. Like desperados waiting for a train. Like desperados waiting for a train. One day I looked up and he's pushing 80, and there's brown tobacco stains all down his chin.
Well, to me, he's one of the heroes of this country. So why is he all dressed up like them old men? He's drinking beer and playing Moon 42, like a desperado waiting for a train. Like a desperado waiting for a train. And then the day before he died, I went to see him. And I was grown and he was almost gone. So we just closed our eyes and dreamed us up a kitchen. Sang another verse of that old song. Come on, Jack, the sucker bitch is coming. We're like desperados waiting for a train. Desperados waiting for a train. Like desperados waiting for a train. Like desperados waiting for a train.
I don't write on the road. It's a different thing. Writing, I have to get real irresponsible. Just sit and look out a window and not do anything for 2 days. You know, just don't even think about anything to try to conjure up some sort of mythical bull, you know, or to remember what really happened, one of the two. But on the road, you're constantly trying to make sure you're on time here and you got time for a nap there and the sound check and do I have time to get a shower so I can get back and no. And that's, to me, is not conducive to writing. It never has been. So I don't even attempt it.
There ain't nothing in the world that I like better than bacon and lettuce and homegrown tomatoes. Up in the morning, out in the garden. Get you a ripe one, do not get a hard one. Plant them in the spring, eat them in the summer. All winter without them's a culinary bummer. I forget all about the sweating and digging. Every time I go out and pick me a big one. Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What'd life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. All picket guys. Well, you can go out to eat, and that's for sure, but it's nothing a homegrown tomato won't cure. Put them in a salad, put them in a stew. Make your very own tomato juice. You can eat them with eggs, eat them with gravy. Eat them with beans, pinto or navy. Put them on your side, put them in the middle. Put a homegrown tomato on a hot cake griddle. Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What'd life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. But nothing homegrown tomato won't cure. Put them in a salad, put them in a stew. Make your very own tomato.
tomato juice. You can eat them with eggs, eat them with gravy, eat them with beans, pinto or navy. Put them on your side, put them in the middle. Put a homegrown tomato on a hot cake griddle. Homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What'd life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. Now I've eyes to change this life I lead. I'd be Johnny Tomato Seed, 'cause I know what this country needs is homegrown tomatoes in every yard you see. But when I die, don't bury me in a box in a cemetery. Out in the garden would be much better, and I could be pushing up homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What'd life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes, homegrown tomatoes. What'd life be without homegrown tomatoes? Only two things that money can't buy, and that's true love and homegrown tomatoes. Oh. Writing songs as opposed to writing prose is where you leave the holes. It's how you allow the listener to use their imagination. It's like good guitar players. It ain't what they play, it's the holes they leave. And it's the same with songwriting, or the way I approach it. It's you don't tell them everything they need to know. You allow them to use their imagination. So they say, oh, I know exactly what he's talking about. That happened to me. Because they imagine that scene. And you don't put every detail in there. Thank you.
Mexico is easy. I wouldn't stay here if I could. Don't come along just to please me. Let's go while the going's good. Same old scene. Let's go down to San Miguel. Let's go be somebody else tonight. Come on, Magdalene. There's a greyhound leaving at midnight. If you came with me, it'd be like a dream.
What sets Texas songwriters apart from anybody else is that unique physical and mental combination of poet and just bigger than life personalities that live life large, but then they get up in the morning and they write poetry. And I think of Willie and Waylon and Towns Van Zandt. These are huge men who write poetry, and it's so Texas and it's so Guy Clark.
Well, we got about one more in us. And somebody did ask for this earlier, and I forgot to do it, so let's do it now. And then you're going home. Don't make me come out there. Tried and true, done about everything there is to do. He worked on freighters, and he worked in bars, and he worked on farms, and he worked on cars. Well, it was white port to put that look in his eye. Grown men get when they need to cry. We sat down on the curb to rest, and his head just fell down on his chest. He says every single day it gets just a little bit harder to handle, yeah. Then he lost the thread and his mind got cluttered and the words just rolled off down the gutter. And he's the elevator man in a cheap hotel in exchange for the rent on a one-room cell. And he's old years beyond his time, no thanks to the world and the white port wine. He said, son, he always called me son, said life for you has just begun. And then he told me the story I'd heard before, how he fell in love with a Dallas whore. I could cut through the years to the very night that it ended in a whorehouse fight, and she turned his last proposal down in favor of being a girl about town. Now it's been 17 years riding line, and he ain't been straight none of the time. Too Too many days of fighting the weather, too many nights not being together. So he died. Was a crumbling picture of a girl in a door and an address in Dallas and nothing more. The welfare people provided the priest. A couple from the mission down the street sang Amazing Grace. No one cried except some lady in black way off to the side. We all left, and she's standing there, the black veil covering the silver hair, and the one-eyed John said her name was Alice, and she used to be a whore in Dallas. So let him roll, Lord, let him roll. I bet he's gone to Dallas, rest his soul. Let him roar. He always said that heaven is just a Dallas hole. Just you let him roar. Lord, let him roar. I bet he's gone to Dallas, rest his soul. Very much. Verlon Thompson.
Guy Clark.
Jack Elliott. Thanks again. We had a great time. Thanks for coming.
To experience more of Sierra Center Stage, visit sierracenterstage.com for additional interviews and performances, plus a schedule of upcoming television shows and performances. SierraCenterStage.com.